It's time for a little slow motion action with Superhot VR. Hey Questers, and welcome to another episode of BMF, the unofficial home for all things Oculus Quest. Keep up to date on Quest news, game reviews, and the latest developments by subscribing to the channel and hitting that notification bell. There is a pretty good chance that unless you're brand new to VR, you've heard about Superhot VR, the slow motion, minimalist, bullet dodging action game that makes you feel like you're Neo who got stuck in a low poly version of the Matrix. This review is really going to come down to two things. If you've played Superhot VR, is it worth playing again on another platform? And as a new user, is it worth buying even though technically it is a couple years old? To answer those questions, let's jack in and find out.
Superhot VR is a unique game in many ways, including its gameplay elements. In Superhot VR, if you aren't moving, neither is the game. This gives you the ability to dodge bullets and even assess situations by staying totally still with bullets flying at you so you know exactly how to get out of their way. The goal is simple. Don't get hit by a bullet and kill all the evil red men. It sounds simple and easy, but if you haven't played it before, then you're in for a surprise. Everything becomes a weapon in the game, from ashtrays to meat cleavers, and of course, various firearms. Each mission has you jumping to different points in an area or room and dispatching the enemies in that location before moving forward. Visually, the game is ultra simple. The environments have little to no detail, just enough so you know what kind of location you're in, and the enemies all look exactly the same, with the exception of the weapon they are using, with their low poly, red naked bodies. Guns and weapons look simple as well, but the whole minimalist, simple visuals make sense when you consider that in the game, you're an agent that is training inside of VR training. Between missions, you'll see a plethora of different PC components scattered around the small room, and you jack into missions by simply picking up a floppy disk, inserting it into the computer, and then putting on your headset. Audio-wise, the game is just as simple. No music and minimal sound effects aside from gunshot noises and the breaking glass sound when you hit an enemy, along with the occasional environmental sounds. The simplicity of both the audio and visual elements, though, are far offset by the gameplay mechanics and the fun level of the game. The uniqueness of time in Superhot leaves you pondering every move of your muscle, and I guarantee if you spend a little while in the game, once you take off the headset, time will feel weird. There is something just so satisfying about dodging bullets and getting that perfectly aimed shot fired mid-dodge to dispatch your creepy red enemies. Now don't tell me you don't find those faceless men at least a little unnerving. It took me about an hour to play through the whole story of the game, but I had played and beat it a couple of times before, so your mileage will vary with how challenging you find the first playthrough. Some people complain about the length of the game for the price, but that isn't where the game ends. There are multiple modes to play after the main game is over, from the endless gameplay mode to other modes like headshots only and hardcore. I haven't spent a lot of time in these modes, but from what I've played, they're fun and make an already challenging game much harder. The real selling point to this version of the game, though, is the fact that, and I know I'm repeating myself, the Quest gives you the freedom to move around in any direction without having to worry about a tether. Superhot VR really is a totally different experience when you can play it in a wide open space with a large guardian and not having to worry about tripping over a cable.
So should you grab Superhot VR in the Oculus Quest? I will answer that question this way. In my opinion, the Quest is the best platform on which to play Superhot by far. The visuals look essentially identical to its PC VR counterparts, but the real thing that seals the deal is having that standalone headset to experience it in. Needless to say, if you've never experienced Superhot VR, then I would highly recommend getting the game, and even if you've played it on another platform, I would recommend at least considering checking it out on the Quest, as it really is that much fun. If you're looking for other Oculus Quest games, check out our other reviews here. Also, please help me out by liking and sharing this video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe for future Oculus Quest content on BMF, the unofficial home for all things Oculus Quest. Happy questing.